Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Franklin Park Art Center. In the town of Beaumont, dancing is a crime, and so is the use of personal electronic devices during this performance. Please turn them off now. We'll wait. Thank you. Loudoun Center Theater now presents Footloose.
Yeah! long way to church this morning, down past the old creek, I heard birds chirping and our own choir warming up in the distance. I was reminded of a line from our great poet, Walt Whitman, who wrote, I hear America singing, and I thought, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we lift our voices and tell the world who we are? So I asked him this morning, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. But we were barely hanging on, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we can stay. Or maybe Mom can find a job that's steady. Or maybe I could stay there for a year. And maybe things won't be so bad. And maybe I won't miss my dad. And maybe we can start a new life here. Start a new life here.
But if Walt Whitman were alive today, what song would he hear America singing? When I turn on television, all I hear is the music of easy sexuality and relaxed morals. I hear rock and roll and the endless chant of pornography, and I ask, why does our Lord allow this? We know God has the power to turn all these records, books, and videos into one big fiery cinder like that. But he doesn't. And why? Because God is testing us. He's watching to see where the real Jews is at. That is why each day we must ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
Have I done the right thing? Picking up my life, packing up the past. That's always right thing. Have I done the right thing? Look at me, look at me. He's trying to do us right. Look at me, look at me.
Parish, two new souls just arrived from Chicago. Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, is it?
Ron.
Speak up, let the Lord hear your voice.
Ron.
Ron.
What a dumb name. Ron McCormick.
Ron, it's an interesting name. Is it short for something?
Nope.
And now I invite you to join my wife and I and our daughter Ariel in this morning's convocation.
Yeah, she just thought he wanted to run off and find himself.
Ren, please.
won't you join us? Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Call me Ethel, please.
Only if you call me by.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, are you all set for school tomorrow?
We took care of that last week. Coach here got it registered.
Hey, Ren, do you hear about that new English teacher who wants to introduce some vulgar novel to the American Lit class?
Slaughterhouse-Five. Yes, Coach, I received several calls.
Slaughterhouse-Five. Oh, cool book, cover to cover. Ha! That is one sick story.
Slaughterhouse-Five.
Do you read much?
Coach, perhaps in another town it's a classic.
Uncle Wes, in any town it's a classic.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy, excuse me. Rusty and the girls are going out for burgers tonight. Can
nope.
I?
Nope, tomorrow's a school day. No.
Daddy!
Ask your mother.
Oh, wait, it's in the car. She said it was okay with her. It's okay with you. So it's okay with you.
10 o'clock.
Great
sir,
Reverend!
Thank you, Reverend.
What'd you say about hot women and listen to the music in your song?
I was like, burn it!
I praise indeed! Wes?
I, on the other hand, thought my dad was never gonna shut up. So then why don't you just talk to him, Ariel? Why? Because he never listens to me in any way. Oh, welcome to Beaumont!
Howdy. You're cute.
Wendy Jo isn't cute.
Uh-huh.
I bet he knows he's cute, don't you think, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
Go away! My leg is that way!
Put your tongue back in your mouth and let's get out of here. See ya.
Where are you going?
Where do you think? Ooh. And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all evening, right?
Wait, you're asking us to lie for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sweet.
Ah!
your friends suggested I might find you here.
Well, we were just on our way, sir.
Your mother thought you might be cold.
Evening, Reverend.
Evening, Reverend.
The girl is mad. She knows what she likes.
Knows what she likes.
What she needs. She's with him tonight. The girl gets around, 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 around. Watch out, this girl gets around.
Met in the church right yesterday. Is this a small town or what? I'm your new classmate.
Howdy! We're quite alone.
Hey, mister, you bumped me.
Sorry.
Don't you ever look where you're going?
I said I was sorry.
Hey, you're that new kid from Chicago, ain't you? Wise guy. Listen, fella, around these parts, you push someone, they push back. And the next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Got it. I got one question for you. Do these on men's clothes where you got that hat?
Well, what's that supposed to be? Some kind of stupid joke?
No, it's a really good joke.
That's it, man. I'm cute!
Oh, you don't kill me! Woo! I get kill me, please! That's what society has to say! Hey! For a good time. You have any clubs?
Nope.
What about movies?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope. Nope, nope, and nope. Oh, but we got a Bowl-O-Rama down by the interstate. That is some fun.
I cannot do what you got to do right now.
What's that?
Nothing.
Whatever.
I never walked the night and run. I don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should. He says, I cannot offer you a bed, so I never found relief, and now I got to move until I have my fill. I can't stand still.
Yeah, I can see that.
That's where I come from. Life's never wrong. I wish I could take you there. Somebody kill me, cuz I can't stand still. No, 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 no.
Young man, what do you think you're doing?
I want to tell the Lord about Chicago. Yeah, Chicago, you know that. That toddling town?
That's not what it looked like.
Oh, that? I'll just show them some steps. Stuff used to do in clubs.
Don't. Just don't.
What? Don't what?
Oh, you mean this?
No, I'm just performing.
Crap.
There's no dancing allowed here.
What? Oh, school property. Not supposed to have any fun.
That sort of remark may pass for wit in Chicago. But here, we speak simply. Let me make this as clear as I can. There is absolutely no dancing of any kind allowed at any time, anywhere, within the town limits of Beaumont.
He's joking, right? He's kidding? Oh, no. Oh, I get it. Jokes on the new kid. Woo!
Mr. Hewitt, would you inform your friend?
It's against the law.
Dancing? Oh, get out! Shut up!
Mr. Clark, sir, Ramsey is very sorry. He was ignorant of our local laws, but I will inform him of his ignorance.
And I will see both of you in my office after school. I'm sure we all have places to be. Gentlemen.
Wow, the way you spoke to Principal Clark, that's like the longest sentence you've ever made.
Anybody survive?
Yeah. When the sheriff's office published the autopsy report, they claimed that they had alcohol and marijuana in their blood. Well, everyone in the town went nuts.
And that's when Gardner Moore got so righteous, he started bringing everything and anything. Liquor, drugs, and rock and roll.
And dancing.
You got it. He even convinced the town council that it was all a sin. And just like that, they passed this law.
Wait. Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power.
He is the law.
Man, how can you all stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice.
Yeah, it's not like Chicago where you can walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I kind of miss that. All living in a small town would be happy. Like one happy family.
Well, let me tell you about that family. There's tongues flapping every time you make a move. There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's heads shaking the minute you cross the line.
And there are eyes everywhere. Careful what you do. Someone's on to you. Careful what you do.
Yeah. Welcome, Jim.
Freshman, is there a brand new gym?
That city kid, I wouldn't let him lick the dirt off my boot. He seems nice.
angry with Ariel. Please tell her why.
I'm not angry, I'm concerned.
Then get to the point. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Okay. Have you seen her with this Chuck Cranston? The last time I walked in on that
Tuesday. You told me.
The boy has a record of arrests by.
And the more you object, the more intrigued she's going to be.
So I should just hold my peace.
I do. And I pray that her infatuation with Chuck Cranston lasts no longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not an overheated delinquent.
Oh, he most certainly was.
This is not funny.
Oh, I'm trying to light the mood.
Well, I can't. I'm concerned about where Ariel is and what she's doing.
You can't expect her to sit home with us.
You know, let's just stop this conversation right here.
Conversation?
Bye.
I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Please, let's not say anything we might regret.
Get her guys in overalls right in the contrast.
like to have a real conversation.
Lily's not capable of a real conversation, but I kind of like that in a guy.
Hey, Ren. How's the new job?
Well, it's already my second day and I haven't been fired, so.
You may have found your future.
I may have. What can I get you?
Diet Coke. I'll have a Hula Burger Dough Patty Chino with extra mayo and an order of fries and a Diet Coke.
Okay. And Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
You know, if Chuck catches you flirting with Ariel, you are a dead man.
He usually doesn't even remember me.
Yeah, well, that uniform kind of makes you look like a dork, so you stick out more.
You're always looking for a fight, aren't you?
Mama says it's in my nature.
Willard, just shut up and tell me what you know about Ariel.
Alright. Well, I know she's been kissed.
A lot.
And she is on you like hop on a slide.
Get out of here.
Mm-hmm. And she loves trouble. And you have proven to everyone in town that you are nothing but T-R-U-B-L.
I was only teasing him.
Girl, Ren is from out of town. Not tell me that doesn't just curl your tail.
You are out of Beaumont so bad. I bet you memorized the bus schedule.
You told us that you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly. And folks, I get to meet guys who amaze me. Ooh, what about Ren?
What about him? He's sort of smart.
He's kind of tall.
And I think he's handsome.
Oh, okay. Oh.
Cute, maybe.
But can he really compete with Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout slash drug dealer who was recently evicted from the trailer park? I don't think so.
Ew.
What?
No.
What's the deal with you and Rusty?
Beats me. I mean, she's pretty. But half the time, I don't even know what the heck she's talking about. She talks faster and louder than any girl I have ever met.
That's because you make her talk crazy.
Really?
If only I could find a guy who'd make the first move. If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
Where all gone?
Yeah.
Where's the streetwise Hercules?
about a day and a half hour ago.
Chuck, I'm sorry.
Don't like you making a fool out of me.
Why is that? You do such a good job of it yourself.
Chuck, we be joining these ladies for dinner. I say meet me at 8, what am I talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm down, honey.
Don't tell me to calm down. Don't you ever tell me what to do. Look, I know what your friends think of me, and that's crap. I'm the best party in this town, baby. Those three dogs ought to be tied up under the porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. A part of that don't you understand?
Oh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot.
Just say
it
again.
I believe the ladies said no. I believe this is none of your business.
Red, don't.
Light at this point. Oh, we haven't been formally introduced. Run the corner. Get your hand out of my face and get your face out of my sight.
Hey, Chuck, you looking for a fight?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go.
Let's go. Wait, don't look at this guy.
Oh, she's one punch. Come on, Chuck.
Hey, hey, hey. We got a problem here.
No, ma'am, the fellas and I were discussing the safety of one of your most valued customers. Do you think I'm funny?
Preston, your pickup truck is in handicap parking, which is a space we reserve for people with physical, not emotional, disabilities.
This is over, Mark.
Come on, Chuck, get down!
Do you want to kiss me?
someday.
Someday? What do you mean someday?
I have a feeling you've been kissed a lot, and I suffer by comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
I think you more than expected. Come on. I'll walk you home.
I try not to go overboard. But then I think, if I can't reach her, how can I face my Lord? Heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle. Still, someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, to spread his word, to ease some pain and to dry some tears. That was the plan. But I might have thought twice if only I knew that I'd spend all of my time saying, no, don't do that. See, everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have rules. So heaven help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven help me.
We're gonna throw a lip right down that boomer right up in
attractive.
You're just asking for a fight.
Bring it on.
Are you ready? Ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I will take on anyone.
Are you ready to go to this town council?
I'll fight City Hall. If there's one thing worth fighting for, it's freedom.
Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. Anything worth the fear, it's worth the fight. No, I can't tie my hands or make me change my plans. I'm crossing the line, jumping the track, taking what's mine and not looking back. If heaven helps the man who fights his way, every day I face a new frontier. I can worry what the world will say.
Got to be a way out.
And the only way out is by train.
No, listen.
Running away will never make you free. Doesn't matter where you go, I guarantee. As long as we hold our ground, we cannot be down. We're shaking our past, breaking our bricks, taking control.
Thank you.
You look so handsome tonight.
Thanks.
But you stuck me in the backseat of a car with a crazy woman who won't stop moving and talking.
Oh, that's because she's excited to be with you.
Well, okay. The problem is...
Yes?
Between you and me...
Uh-huh.
I can't do it.
You can't do it.
No, sir.
Oh, well, that's okay. It's only the first date.
What?
People don't do it on the first date. Even people in Chicago don't do it on the first date.
No way.
I swear.
Oh, well, that makes me feel a whole lot better.
Okay, great. Let's go dance.
Dance? What the heck do you think I've been talking about this whole time?
You said you could do it. I thought you meant.
Kissing? Please, any idiot can do that. I can't dance.
What?
Give the guy a break.
But it's not natural. so I guess she's busy now.
She and the girls went to Wendy Jo's to study.
Really? I was just at Wendy Jo's and she said that she left hours ago with Rusty.
Oh.
Who is it by? Mr. Cranston?
Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
It's a bit late, isn't it, Mr. Cranston?
It certainly is. That's why I'm surprised she's not at home.
So am I. Good evening, Mr. Cranston. And remember, next time, got a front door for our guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Jo's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
Did you know about this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I hear an explanation from her.
You know, it was bad enough when she was going out with that Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night with that punk who's campaigning to challenge me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Oh, Rusty, Wendy, Joe, and me, we were studying and,
Don't even bother.
We know you weren't at Wendy Jo's.
I can't believe you guys are checking up on me.
Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
And I'm concerned for your well-being.
Then how come when I'm home, you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I feel? Because the minute I walk out that door, wham, suddenly you're the concerned parent.
Shaw, she doesn't mean that.
Stop taking her side. She has to start answering for herself.
Oh, I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Shaw!
I've never hit anyone.
I know.
You're losing her, Vi. She's become so willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
And her spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey, while part of her is dying to run away? Can't you hear what she's trying to say? Can you find it in your soul to accept her? If she stumbles on your holy path, do you have to reprimand? Or are there ways to make her understand without using the back of your hand? Can't you remember when we were that age, pumped up with promise and wrestling with rage?
Before that
she wants to die for us.
No, you, I'm talking to you. This is not how you make a sign.
Hey!
Right?
And whatever, okay, listen, our friend, what we're trying to say is that you're going to be talking to the town council, so don't mumble. Now, go on, do that one more time.
Members of the town council, dancing is not a crime.
Yeah.
If anything, everybody had a chance to holler at the meeting to dance all night. When they were traveling back before the fire, they were laughing at dance when the crops came in.
Keep going. Rand, keep going.
So they would dance, whether the reason or the circumstance. They had a reason to have a party in their pants, so they would dance, dance, dance!
He said, party in your pants.
I get it. No, okay, cool, guys, all right. Rand, what we're trying to say is not that your speech is bad, it's just that it's no good.
Right? What am I supposed to do? I've rewritten it 9 times.
Well, you're going to be facing Reverend Moore and some of the stubbornest people in Beaumont.
Yeah, you already got plenty of people more than that.
Yeah, folks are picking sides,
and they're not picking yours.
Maybe I'll just forget it. The thing the town council's gotten way out of hand.
Oh, come on. We didn't mean to discourage you.
Come on, after all the posters we painted,
all the flyers we passed out,
people at school are climbing the walls.
Yeah, so hang in there, okay? You just gotta rethink your approach. Now, Mama says.
Are you kidding? No, I'm not talking.
Who cares?
Now, hold on just 1 minute, okay? Brent, you listen up. Everything I ever learned that gets me through the worst, I learned at my mama's knee. Anytime I'm turned around, I turn to mama first. And memorize, to memorize what mama says to me. Now mama ain't been wrong yet, and I'm the living proof. Whatever that's worth, I should. Mama says don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now who can argue with that? Mama says don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. Now who knows where it's at? And Mama says it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down.
You can't back down, Rand.
Now, Rand, you know you had the pleasure of meeting my mama, but these fine boys have not. Come on, help me out here, fellas.
Mama says,
don't drink hot coffee lying down there. Don't even give it a thought.
It's a mess, Mama says.
Never anything
that's bigger than your head.
Is she a weasel, what?
Oh, yes.
Everyone knows Mama's crazy, but she's got some good ideas, okay? Now, watch this.
Mama said,
what you believe in is all you really own. And I believe that she's right.
Mama said,
if you got doubts, well then, boy, you are not alone. Thank you.
It's so like a clue.
stay at the town council tomorrow.
That reminds me, you'll need this.
The Holy Bible.
I marked all the passages.
Oh, this is great. Where did you find all of this?
Are you kidding?
Thank you.
God, the perfect love was hard to find. I'd almost given up. You must have read my mind.
And all those dreams I saved for a rainy day, they're finally coming true. I share them all with you, and now we hold the future in our hands. My name is Ren McCormick, and on behalf of most of the senior class of Beaumont High, I move that ordinance is 416 to allow public dancing within the towns of Beaumont be abolished.
Yeah! Yeah! Thank you. Talking about Anna Willard Hewitt of 385 Oakdale Street would like to second that motion. Thank you very much. Mr. McCormick, you wish to change the law because you want to throw a dance. That is your right. But it is my duty to challenge any enterprise which, in my experience, fosters the use of liquor, the abuse of drugs, and most importantly, celebrates spiritual corruption. And I think you're going to find that most folks in this community agree with me.
Yeah, you got that right!
Now, if anyone can convince me that there's no danger in your raucous party plans, I might reconsider my stand. But for now, no, I can't condone it.
I believe a vote is in order.
Excuse me, this is your discussion.
and we're discussing.
Coach! Coach!
You think you
coach!
Sit down. I believe Mr. McCormick has a right to be heard.
I just wanted to say a few words because I think the idea scares a lot of people and it shouldn't. From the oldest of times, people have danced for many reasons. They dance for the cross to be plentiful and for their hunt to be good. They dance to celebrate the community spirit and they dance to celebrate. And that's the kind of dancing that we're talking about.
Mr. McCormick, we don't
want to be told. Excuse me, Reverend. Aren't we told in Psalms 149, praise the Lord, sing to him a new song, let him praise his name and dance? And what about King David's Reverend Sanders? What did King David do? What did King David do? What did King David do? Oh, King David, he did before the Lord with all his might, leaping and dancing before the Lord, leaping and dancing. And Ecclesiastes assures us that there's a purpose under heaven. There's a time to laugh, there's a time to weep. There's a time to mourn, and there's a time to dance. There's a time for this law, but not anymore. This is our time to celebrate life. That's the way it's always has been, the way it should always be, and the way that it should be now. Thank you. And they would be snubbing my mom at the market, and they would be glaring at me on the streets. If those wounds were healed, they wouldn't be boycotting my uncle's business, and you would be fixing the vote of the town council.
I thought it was time to put an end to this nonsense.
Oh, nonsense?
Nonsense!
This was up for a little dance, and all people could think about was Tawny Britt's accident and four kids.
Mr. McCormick!
I know your son was one of them, sir, and I'm truly sorry for your loss, but honoring their memory by shutting the world out is not worth it. I'm sure you have all the answers. No, I
And you're gonna set me straight.
I didn't say
How that. Can you presume to know what I've been through? You don't have a clue. Good evening, Mr. McCormick.
Please, if I could only...
Mr. McCormick, I'd like to be alone.
Sir, you already are! We both are. You and me. We both lost somebody. And people think they understand when they really don't. I bet you stop and wonder 100 times a day and ask yourself, why? I know I do. I wonder why my dad left. Was it something that I did? Was it something I didn't do? Could I have made him stare? Could I have made him come back? But I can't. I shouldn't have to tell you that. You should know what it's like.
I do.
I know I came to this town frustrated and angry. It felt so good to kick up a fuss. And I know I upset a lot of people, but I'm tired of looking back and I can't stand still.
I've noticed.
Well, I'm gonna go now. I know that you're gonna have to make a decision with this whole town council meeting about that, but thanks for listening.
Ren.
I'm sorry your father and never get to know you. Thanks.
Daddy?
Oh, I didn't hear you there.
I heard voices.
That was our friend Ren. He sure asks a lot of questions.
And what'd you tell him?
For once, I had very little to say. I think I'm running out of answers.
Daddy, I know that this is hard for you. And I know that I don't make it any easier. I just don't know that I believe in all the same things that you believe in. But I believe in you. I'll get some rest. You have a sermon in the morning.
If I can only figure out what to say.
You will.
When souls come to me for protection, I guide them whatever the cost. But while I've been giving direction, maybe it's me who got lost. Heaven, very troubled heart. You see, my friends, as your minister, I should be helping you to find the joy in your lives. Last night, I realized that I hadn't been doing that. After all, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago when the lives of four young people ended along the Pattani Bridge. Everyone in the community lost someone that night. A neighbor, a friend, a child. I laid down my burdens and exhilarating, and it was terrifying. This morning, I offer you that same opportunity. The senior class of Beaumont High has asked permission to throw a dance. Ren, I think that's a good idea.
Beautiful.